That populist message struck a chord with many voters. But why? Growing public discontent has turned into a major political force.
The policy changes and the people who support them are all part of an ideology known as populism.
Populism is generally a sense that the elite are corrupt and that there is a group which stands for the will of the people.
And the message constantly portrayed in the media that economic inequality was growing made matters worse, or so McCloskey controversially claims.
It's that the politicians and some academics, indeed, and some a lot of journalists have emphasized it, have said, oh, you poor people, your inequality has increased, which is dubiously true.
And so what you're saying is that when people like myself say, look at the growing inequality, the people who might otherwise have said, I'm doing okay,
not to worry,
suddenly are now alerted to their lower status. Is
exactly.
That what?
Exactly.
That Americans feel they're falling behind as other people, mainly the Chinese, surge ahead. And that has led many Americans to despair, as highlighted by the opioid crisis in so many of the pockets of populism. Or so argues University of Michigan economist Lisa Cook.
I've lived in Europe and I've lived in Russia, and I think that I've seen the worst of what populism can bring.
Including, says Cook, the heavy drinking that followed the collapse and loss of international status in the former Soviet Union.
All of a sudden, Russia was exposed to these global forces. What happened? Life expectancy for men fell to rates that we saw in developing countries. You can say that the opioid crisis is the same kind of crisis, sort of placating the nervousness, the anxiety that people have.
So opioids are the vodka of America?
Yes,